Hi students, now I am going to teach motion of a charged particle under crossed electric and magnetic field. So in this video we are going to discuss about the motion of the charged particle under crossed electric and magnetic field. Okay, so motion of the charged particle under the two crossed field, one is electric field and another one is magnetic field. Okay students, so for this we consider the experimental setup. For this we are taking the parallel plate capacitor, already you know, okay. So in this parallel plate capacitor, one side it has a positive charge and the another side it has a negative charge. So between this there is okay, so there is a electric field positive to negative. So you need to join this line. Right. Okay, so this is one of the electric field, and then here this setup is also arranged in uniform magnetic field. You can say this is a uniform magnetic field. There is a uniform magnetic field. Now we consider a charge Q. It has a mass is m. It is moves with velocity v. It is entered to the field. Okay. So that only we are going to discuss motion of the charged particle under crossed electric and magnetic field. So when the charge is entered to the magnetic field, means already we know that here the velocity of the particle, it is not perpendicular to the direction of the magnetic field. Here when the charged particle, it is moves in a uniform magnetic field, it does not moves in a circular path. Here it is moves in the form of the helix. Already we know that it is moves in the form of the helix. So like this, when the charged particle is move enter to the electric field, means there is also experience of force, that is one of the Coulomb force. Okay, so when the charged particle is entered to the magnetic field, there is experience of magnetic Lorentz force. At the same time it is also entered to the electric field, means there is also experience a Coulomb force. So when the charged particle is entered to the setup, there is experience a two type of forces. One is Coulomb force and another one is magnetic Lorentz force. So here if you consider this is one of the positive charges, means here positive charges enter to the magnetic field, there is experience a Lorentz force. That Lorentz force is acting upward direction. If the positive charges is entered to the electric field, means there is experience a Coulomb force. That Coulomb force is has the magnetism Q into E. It is also acting downward direction. So from this there is experience a magnetic Lorentz force and Coulomb force is acting in opposite direction. So from this we can calculate this, that value of the force, the resultant force, means the resultant force is calculated by using the sum of the magnetic Lorentz force and Coulomb force. The sum of the Lorentz force means that is QVB plus Q into E. So from this the Q is common, so it will be taken outside. What is remaining here for the Coulomb force? It has a value, this is Q into E, Q outside, so remaining, plus magnetic Lorentz force Q into V into B, the Q on outside, so remaining V vector into B vector. Okay, so this is from the cross multiplication. Okay, we can write this. Okay students, so already I explained to you. So there is experience of magnetic Lorentz force and the Coulomb force, both are acting in opposite direction. So we can write that balanced each other, so we can write that the Coulomb force is equal to, in magnitude, the Coulomb force is equal to Lorentz force. So we can write that is Q into V naught into B. Here we can write the V naught means the distance of the velocity of the particle, there is experience a magnetic Lorentz force. So V means there is a velocity of the particle, there is experience a electric field, there is a Coulomb force. Okay, so both are speed, velocity of the charged particle, velocity of the charged particle. So here we can write the Q is equal to Q into V naught into B. So from this Q cancelled, so we can calculate the values of the V naught. What is the V naught? V naught is equal to E divided by B. V naught is equal to E divided by B. Students, this principle, that is V naught is equal to E divided by B, this principle, it is used in the Bainbridge mass spectrograph to separate the isotope. Okay, so this principle, it is used in the mass spectrometer, Bainbridge mass spectrometer. That question we will go to discuss in 6th unit, okay, atomic physics. In this unit, we are going to discuss about that Bainbridge mass spectrometer. So this is used to, this principle is used in the mass spectrometer, so to separate the isotope. In mass spectrometer, to separate the isotopes, we are using this principle. So here, this equation, it is gives, for the given magnitude of the electric field E and the magnetic field B, the force act only on the particle moving with a particular speed, the V naught is equal to E divided by B. Okay, so when the charged particle is entered to the magnetic field and the electric field, means the velocity of the charged particle V naught is equal to E divided by B, it is depend upon the electric field and the magnetic field. So here from this equation we conclude that the speed of the particle or the speed of the charge, the speed of the charge or the velocity of the charge is independent to the mass of the particle and the charge. Mass of the particle and the charge. Only here the speed of the particle is dependent upon the electric field and the magnetic field. Okay, by proper choice of the electric and the magnetic field, the particle with a particular speed can be selected. Such an arrangement of field is called velocity selector. Okay, so by applying the electric field, magnetic field, we can control the speed of the charged particle. So this speed of the charged particle is called as instruments. So by using the instruments, we can adjust the electric field and the magnetic field, that is called velocity selector.